in HD. 12 News at 10 starts now.
New leadership takes over at Beaumont ISD, but before they move forward, they must address part of the district's past.
The Beaumont ISD Board of Managers proposed the termination of Dr. Timothy Shagwa's term contract.
In one of its first votes, the newly appointed Board of Managers proposes firing Superintendent Dr. Timothy Shagwa. Find out what they decided on other layoffs tonight as well. Hello and welcome to 12 News HD. I'm Kevin Steele. Jackie is off tonight. Thank you very much for coming by. The eight members of BISD's Board of Managers were sworn into their new positions at tonight's board meeting, taking over for trustees whose authority has been suspended by the state. And while they were warmly received, the managers know they have a tough road ahead. 12 News anchor Angel San Juan joining us with day one of BISD's new beginnings. Angel?
Kevin, the Board of Managers unanimously voted for the proposed termination of Superintendent Dr. Timothy Shagwa. However, managers postponed making a decision on teacher layoffs, saying they wanted more time to make sure they made the right decisions. But as for tonight, it was a time to celebrate for battle-weary taxpayers, teachers, and students. Texas Commissioner of Education Michael Williams received a rock star's welcome at Monday night's Beaumont ISD board meeting. Many in the audience were even wearing his trademark bow tie.
I like the bow tie idea. I'm trying to take over the world one neck at a time, so I like the bow tie idea.
For the time being, it's just a takeover of the school district. However, Williams likes to see it as just a passing of the baton, with control of BISD remaining in local hands.
When I leave here and get on the plane, I'm leaving Beaumont to Beaumont, and I am confident that Beaumont can heal itself.
Commissioner Williams is also confident in the seven members of the Board of Managers he's appointed, along with the new interim superintendent, Vern Butler. However, the president of the Board of Managers, retired Lamar University President Jimmy Simmons, cautions that solving BISD's financial problems won't be easy.
It's a wonderful honeymoon, but we know we're going to have to make some tough decisions, and we just hope that we can continue to unite this community and not look back, look forward.
And judging by the reception the managers received during their first meeting, they have community support. We could only find one lone voice against them.
It is not elected, this was appointment. And this is a farce, it's a shame, it's an insult to even give the attention they've been given tonight to these individuals.
But many here know the Board of Managers cannot right the ship alone. That's why Donna Forgas, who's been waiting for this day a long time, advised her fellow citizens to remain involved.
Many people over the last year have asked me, how did this happen? I simply tell them, it happened when you were sleeping. Hopefully, this community will never sleep again.
And Kevin, Dr. Shagwa will have 15 days to appeal the proposed termination. As for any monetary settlement he might receive, that has yet to be decided. BISD's new attorneys, who were hired tonight, are looking into the matter, so board members couldn't really elaborate on it.
For those folks tonight, they're very excited.
It was a celebratory spirit there. Yeah, they were very excited. A lot of work ahead, but they felt that at least for tonight, it was a time to be joyful.
There you go. Angel, thank you very much. There are still two pending state investigations into BISD dealing with cheating allegations and attendance irregularities. Commissioner Williams says he's not decided if his agency will complete the attendance investigation or leave it to the Board of Managers. As for the cheating investigation, Williams says that is in the hands of the Jefferson County District Attorney. In the morning, Jefferson County DA Corey Crane